Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. I really do appreciate all you people that get involved on my channel and watch my videos and stuff like that. And a big welcome to all you newcomers. I appreciate everyone that comes to my channel, I really do. You're all wonderful people, and all the material, everybody else that comes to my channel, all the material you've put out, I love watching it. I literally love watching it all. I spend a lot of time watching all your videos, and I really do enjoy it. I've never come across a bad one yet. And, you know, a thumbs up to everybody. It's all great stuff, this. And YouTube is helped me along a lot. I got to admit, it kind of has put my mind into gear, so I can accept things, because there's other people far worse off than me, and I see all this on YouTube, and it's great that you can see this on YouTube and believe it. I mean, with the mainstream press, I was stuck with the mainstream press, and I'll tell you what, it's depressing, because all they seem to say, you know, it just seems to be vote Conservative, or, you know, come join us and be a paedophile with the BBC. That's what it all seems to be about, that. Stuff like that, you know, that it's barmy, this world. But like I said, you know, please leave any answers, any questions you might have, because, you know, one of the things I'm doing, I'm in research. I'm doing research. I'm researching this subject before I actually put it out. And it's regarding, like, what I'm just going to, I'll just call it, where does the money go? You know, because I'll just give one little hint about how people work. I know people in different countries, the governments have, like in Australia and Queensland, I do know that they don't have a road tax there, they don't have an MOT or anything like that. You're just required by law to insure your vehicle, but your vehicle, you need to keep your vehicle in good condition and safe condition, or the police will come down if they pull you up, and I think that's fair. But the thing is, you don't need to pay road tax, and you don't need an MOT. That saves a lot of money. It saves a lot of money. If we had the same system in this country, I mean, New Zealand, you don't even need to insure your vehicle. But what the top of it is, I mean, we pay road tax in this country, and it averages, you know, you can pay as low as 20 quid a year. And you can pay as high as £1,000 a year just to drive your vehicle on a public road. Now, that's called road tax. For what I understood, the reason for it being set up. Now, in Australia, it's done by toll, but you only pay for bridges and for what I gather, tunnels. When I was over in Australia, I mean, we must have done about 10,000 mile, and I think her uncle, it cost him probably about $30. That's all it cost him with the bridges and tunnels we went through. That's what because I asked him at the end of. We went up from Queensland, from the. The Gold Coast, and we went right through to Alice Springs, and it cost about. I asked him how much it cost total. He said it's about $3, something like that. I mean, if I was to add up journeys that I would make in this country going across bridges and tunnels, I probably wouldn't pay anything per year on road tax. But anyway, for what I know, the money off the bridges and all that goes into spending on the roads. In this country, that's the same with the road tax. It's called vehicle exercise duty. And it's road tax. That's what we call it. It's road tax or car tax. And it's a tax on your vehicle, so that you can use it on a public road. Now, for what the government has always said, you know, the road tax is actually a tax on the vehicle to improve the roads and to keep the roads maintained and stuff like that. So at present now, I'm just checking up to see how many cars is registered in this country. And try and find out how much DVLA, that's our driver's and licensed vehicle centre, agency is, to find out how much revenue do they get per year? How much do they have coming in? And then take a look at our roads. I mean, our roads for the past 10 years has been nothing but potholes. Some roads are closed because they're too bad to drive across. You know, and the smaller side roads, they just don't seem to be care. We're getting floods now, and they're washing bridges away. We've had worse floods than what we've had, and then bridges stood because the maintenance ain't there. It isn't there anymore. What is all that road tax? Where's all that money going? It's not going on the roads. It's only people, but you know, all these people that don't know what the road tax is, there, yeah. But there's more to it. There's a lot more. You know, I would be covering quite a lot of the taxes in this country and find out. Let's see if we can find out where the money's going. That's for another video. But anybody got any suggestions, any questions, any answers, please, please drop a comment below. I'll get round to it. Anyway, this video is another, it's a review. It's not a review. It's just a few people have asked me what I fill them with. Well, at present now, I've got a Nokia. What is it? A Nokia 6 or something? And it's got a fantastic camera on. This is what I'm shooting this video with. When I'm in the house, I use my Nokia, a Nokia phone, because it's great for this. I don't like zooming on it or anything like that. So what I do is I just use the stand, the phone stand, selfie stick, just in the house, basically, you know, around the house. If I go into my shed, I will use this baby. And this is my 4K camera. I'm just waiting for two more batteries for it. I've just ordered them, two spare batteries, because the batteries only last roughly about 20 minutes in it. So I'm just waiting for the batteries in it. I did do a review of this on my last channel when I first got it. So this is not a review. It's just to answer some people's questions on what I fill them with. And my sound, what I use for my sound. I'm just getting hold of one of my things now. Is this. Which again, I've done... Oops, sorry about that. Oh, this one's got a bit tangled up. One moment. Oh, there it is there. And I use these lapel mics. I also have a camera boom outside what I've made. If for people that haven't seen it, I'll show that at some stage. And that has a built-in twin stereo microphone. This is a lapel microphone. And I have, for people that remember... I went outside to do a thing with my new hat on, and a bird pooped on me. And all it basically is this, and I just push it into there. Now, when you've got a microphone, a lapel mic, because you can get it right up to your, you know, on your lapel, on your collar, it does now pick the sound up brilliantly. And if, you know, the heaviest, I've had heaviest of winds, and I've talked with this on, and I'm amazed at the sound quality. And these are just cheap 99 pence lapel mics, what you get from China. And I bought half a dozen. They're fantastic, truly are. And you put one of these little windbreaker, I think it's called. I call it a fairy bow. You put one of these on. That's just fell off there because I haven't stuck it on. What it is, there's a hole in it, you can't see it. And you have to affix, do it on camera, and you have to fix it in and pull it over the mic, over the microphone, and then it doesn't come off. You have to literally pull it off. And I can't get in there. All right. Can you see? I'm trying to just get it so that I can open. There's the hole there where it goes into. And you push it in and you pull it right over the microphone, and... that's it, and it doesn't help with the clip in the road, like you've got to move this bit out of the road, but that's how it goes on, and it's brilliant. It really does. So if you're outside, if you're out and about, you're doing selfies, whatever, plug one of these in, get it stuck on. The cables on them are brilliant. I think there's about 6 foot length of cable, more actually. they're what you get. But I got this one with a fancy cable on, the cloth cables, and that's what I use for sound, and it really does work. It's fantastic. You don't need expensive stuff, and that the sound outside on a windy day is absolutely brilliant. It's brilliant. You should try it, people, if anyone's not using them. And this is my it's a cheapie. It was on last year. I think I paid 15 quid for it. And it's a 4K high definition. It's a HDR, look, high definition. There's all the things it does on there. Is this when this focuses? It's got 24 megapixel, full HD, and all that lot. And it's absolutely brilliant. It's brilliant. It's just a matter of, like, you just press that button there and everything's automatic. You just got record. Press a few of these buttons. This screen actually flips right over. You know, so you're not stuck for having the screen in one specific position. You can move that wherever you want and actually use the screen. It's a nice big screen. So you can see, I mean, my eyesight's failing. And it's, how many times zoom is it? Right, let's have a look. 16 times zoom. There's the zoom button on top. That one there. And it's just, that's zoom out, zoom in and that's zoom out. Brilliant. And then you have the light, I think. The light is, you press the light, it's got twin LED lights and they're very powerful at the top there. And they don't have light the area up for you. So, yeah, this is what I use for, there's this called, it's a DVC, digital video camera. And I paid about 15 quid for, I think it was, from eBay. And they still sell them. And they're actually a top seller on eBay, these ones. And it's brilliant. It's not a Sony or anything like that. And I do get true. Well, you see my videos. The videos, especially the ones outside, where you see them outside, that's what I use on them. So, yeah, I get the 4K. And as you've seen on a video a few videos back, I've got a 360 camera now, which I'm experimenting with at the moment. So I get, you know, when the summer comes in, oh, this winter's over with, I'll get some 360 footage and put some of that up, you know, because you can sit there and control it with your TV remote or your computer, whatever. And this one, I got the leads with it and all that, but I've actually got them. You'd even get a user manual and it's in English, but it's a fantastic camera, so cheap, 15 quid, and it takes I think it's up to 64 gig. It has to be a class 10. You've got to get top of the range SD cards for them. Get that. And I've had this now for over a year now, and it works. Still works perfect. Still runs perfect. Still. And you get, you know, all this comes free with it. The lovely case to pack it in. Keep it nice and safe inside there, so that it doesn't get any dings or anything like that. So I was thinking about putting a cover on the front of it, but that was last year, but the lens has never got damaged or nothing, so I don't really think I need to put a cover on the front of it. I think I put that in wrong, but that's how it goes anyway. So yes, it is a fantastic camera. I am more than pleased with it, more than pleased with the price, more than pleased with the product, and it was a nice little steal from eBay. You know, you can't fall off for that price. 15 quid, I've had it over a year, and it gives excellent quality video and pictures. And then when, the only bad thing about it is that the sound on that actual camera is not too grand. So I use this lapel mic, but I do that with my phone too. So that's everything going on. So I think I've covered everything there regarding what I've video on. And as I said, I've got these two cameras we use now. I have another one, a GoPro. It's not a GoPro, it's a high definition, I forgot the name of it, Exovan, and I've had that about 3 years now. Fantastic. It's HD 1080p though, and it's a wonderful camera which I use to chuck about. And I've just got the 360 camera which I'll be using I'm just messing about with it, learning how to use it, and then I'll be getting some 360 videos ready. Anyway, on that note, I'll give you an update on the Jamie. I'll do the next video, you know, similar to the rant type video, you know, similar to the Jamie Oliver one. And if anybody can think of anybody, you know, please, why don't you know, other people, why don't you make videos like that so we can all sit and watch and comment on each other's videos and let, you know, we can all, it's a way of praising if you've ever gone getting to know each other, to be honest. Anyway, on that note, like I said, I really do appreciate everyone coming to my channel. I really do enjoy your company. Well, goodbye.